Fall sports season officially concluded last week in Columbus with three MAC schools winning state football titles. Attendance at Ohio Stadium up more than 50% than last year's games in Stark County. Austin Scott featuring slam dunks and state titles in this week's Layfield Welding Top 5 Plays of the Week.
Boys basketball making its first appearance on the top five plays. Wayne Trace at Van Wert. Ethan Linder drives baseline for the Raiders and gets the foul and the pretty reverse layup off glass. Great adjustment in midair by the sophomore. The Raiders also claim the fourth spot this week. Linder gets the steal and passes to Davidson. Law 2, please. Slams it home. The first of many dunks to be featured on the winter edition of the top five plays. Raiders also get the win 68-57. At number three this week, Coldwater making their sixth straight state final appearance, taking on Canton Central Catholic at the Horseshoe. Brody Hoying had a big night. 21 carries, 236 yards, and six total touchdowns, including this one capped off with a somersault. Coldwater wins big and raises the state championship trophy for the third consecutive year. Marion local Flyers taking the runner-up spot with their performance at the Horseshoe on Saturday morning. J.C. Guttemiller with a touchdown on the second play from scrimmage, and here comes another. Jukes out a defender at the line, and then watch this. Nice stiff arm at the 20-yard line. 160 yards rushing and three touchdowns for the senior. And how many times have we witnessed this? Dustin Rethman heaves it downfield, and look at Hunter Wilker go up and get it for the touchdown. Watch again as Wilker actually reels it in from behind the head of a St. Paul defender. No idea how he was able to hold on to that one. Doesn't matter. The Flyers complete the perfect season and stay on top for the fourth year in a row. Finster getting back to Ohio Stadium for the first time in 25 years tops the countdown this week. Down by three in the final minutes of the game, Jason Schultz with the onside kick bounces off a Kirtland up man, and Schultz recovers it near midfield. Wildcats take over. Josh Nixon stepping back, surveying the field, and delivers to Eli Wolf. Wolf shakes off one defender and slips past another. 51 yards later, the Eastern Michigan commit gets into the end zone for the state championship winning score. Great camera work by Mark the Shark Coons there. Wildcats finish the year with a 12-3 mark and bring home the big trophy for the first time since 1989. Sadly, fall sports have made their last hurrah on the weekly countdown, but that means basketball, bowling, wrestling, and more will begin to jam-pack the top five plays next week. Thanks as always to Layfell Welding for their support, and we urge all of our viewers to visit their two locations for all of your supply and rental needs.